Hey, you ever wonder why your aquarium plants seem to be stuck in slow motion? Here's the truth. You're probably using the wrong lighting, and it's killing their growth. Most aquarium owners unknowingly sabotage their tanks every single day. Want to know how to fix it? Let's dive in. Hey, lighting isn't just about making your tank look pretty. It's the life force behind every thriving aquascape. Without the right light, your plants can't photosynthesize properly. Algae takes over, and your dream aquascape becomes a nightmare. But the good news, with a few adjustments, you can transform your aquarium into a lush underwater jungle. And it all starts with understanding the power of lighting. Hey, here's the problem. Most aquarium lights on the market claim to do it all. They promise vibrant plants, clear water, and happy fish, right? But reality hits when your plants turn yellow, algae takes over, and you're left wondering, what went wrong? Sound familiar? You're not alone. It happened to me too. The challenge isn't just picking a light. It's knowing how much light, what kind of light, and for how long. Too little and your plants starve. Too much and you've got an algae apocalypse. And then there's the technical jargon. PAR, Kelvin, spectrum. What does it all mean? Well, let me break it down step by step so you can finally get it right. A light is energy, and your plants need it to grow. But not all light is created equal. What your plants actually need is a specific range of light called the photosynthetically active radiation, or PAR spectrum. This is light in the 400 to 700 nanometer range, basically the wavelengths plants use for photosynthesis. Many budget aquarium lights don't provide enough PAR, or they focus on the wrong part of the spectrum. So if you've been using cheap LEDs from the pet store, chances are they're not cutting it. Look for lights that explicitly mention their PAR output on the box. Not all plants have the same lighting needs. Low light plants like Java fern and Anubias can thrive in moderate lighting. But if you're trying to grow demanding species like carpet plants or red stems, you'll need high intensity lighting. Hey, here's a pro tip. Match your light to your plants, not the other way around. Research your plants you have and their specific requirements. Kelvin measures the color temperature of your light. For aquariums, the sweet spot is between 6,000 K and 8,000 K. This mimics natural daylight and provides a balanced spectrum that supports plant growth while still looking visually appealing. Hey, avoid anything too yellow, like below 5,000 K, or too blue, which is above 10,000 K. These extremes can either promote algae growth or fail to support plant health. Plants need a consistent photo period, usually 8 to 10 hours per day. We tend to stick with 8. Too little and they don't get enough energy. Too much and algae runs rampant. Invest in a timer for your lights. This ensures consistently and eliminates the guesswork. Start with 8 hours per day and adjust based on how your plants and algae respond. Here's the secret. Light alone isn't enough. To maximize plant growth, you need to pair your lighting with CO2 injection and liquid fertilizers. Now, I will tell you, we don't use CO2. Think of it like a triangle: light, CO2, and nutrients. CO2 injection can seem intimidating, but it's a game changer. If you're not ready for a full setup, try using liquid carbon supplements as a starting point. And don't forget to dose fertilizers regularly to provide essential nutrients like iron and potassium. Hey, let's talk about the pitfalls. One of the biggest mistakes is blasting your tank with high intensity light without balancing it with CO2 and fertilizers. This almost always leads to algae outbreaks. Another mistake? Using a one-size-fits-all approach. Every tank is different. The depth of your tank, the type of plants, and even the positioning of your light all play a role in how effective your setup will be. So here's the aha moment. The right lighting setup can completely transform your aquarium. It's not just about aesthetics. It's about creating a thriving ecosystem where plants grow like crazy, fish are healthier, and algae stays in check. It's the difference between a tank that frustrates you and one that brings you joy every time you look at it. So, to recap, understand the PAR spectrum, match your lighting to your plant's needs, use the right Kelvin rating, and maintain a consistent photo period, and balance your light with CO2 and nutrients. Avoid the common mistakes, and you'll be amazed at what your aquarium can become. Hey, lighting isn't just a tool. It's the key to unlocking your tank's full potential. Don't settle for mediocre when your aquascape could be extraordinary. Hey, you want more tips to take your tank to the next level? Watch this next video or hit subscribe. Stay inspired, and I will see you there.